Hello everyone, today we will discuss the current affairs of 10th December 2023. The important news of the Hindu is, are crimes against women on the rise? Are crime against women on the rise? In that, we will see the according to the National Crime Record Bureau. According to National Crime Record Bureau, crime rates may have declined in 2022. According to the National Crime Record Bureau, the crime rate may have declined in 2022, but crime against women may rise 4% in 2022 compared to 2021. It is big issue. The recently report of National Crime Record Bureau, they said, it said the crime record may have declined in 2022, but crime against women rose 4% in 2022 compared to 2021. Majority of crimes against women are, first one is cruelty by husband or his relatives was 31%. Kidnapping and abduction of women is 19%. Assault on women is 18% and rape is 17%. 4.5 lakh cases of crime against women were registered in 2022. As per the National Crime Record Bureau, in 2022, 4.5 lakh cases of crime against women were registered. In equivalent to nearly 51 FIR every hour. Highest cases in India is Delhi. Recorded is 14 to 47. Okay. We will see the what are the laws made by the government of India for the safety of women. The first one is the Immoral Trafficking Prevention Act 1961. The second one is the Commission of Sati Act 1987. The next one is Protection of Women from Domestic Violence Act 2005. And another important law is Sexual Harassment of Women at Workplace 2005. These are the laws which is made by the India for the safety of women. Let us move to the next important news in the Hindu of the Hindu is, just wait. In Telangana yesterday, this is important news for Telangana students. The portfolio allocated to minister in the new Telangana cabinet. Portfolios were allocated to ministers in the new Telangana cabinet. Let us see which are the portfolios which is allocated to the ministers. The first one is Revanth Reddy. He is the CM of Telangana. And he allocated portfolio was Ministry Administration and Municipal Administration and Urban Development. And second one is Sri Bhagwati Vikram Mallu. His Finance and Planning. And Sri Uttam Kumar Reddy is irrigation and CAD, and Sri Raja Narasimha, he got road and building ministry, and Sridhar Babu, he is IT ministry, and then Srinivas Reddy, he got revenue and housing, and Ponnam Prabhakar, he got the portfolio of transport, and another one is Konda Surekha, ministry is environment and finance, forest, and Anasuya Sitakka, she got Panchayat Raj and Rural Development Ministry. And another one is Nageshwara Rao, Agriculture Ministry, and Jupalli Krishna Rao, Prohibition and Exercise Ministry. This is important for Telangana student yesterday allocated to ministry which is ruling government and the ruling government. And another news is USA, South Korea and Japan to set up action on North Korea cyber threat. US, South Korea and Japan agreed a new initiative to respond North Korea's threat in cyberspace, including satellite. These three countries, USA, South Korea and Japan, agreed new initiatives on the response of North Korea threat in cyberspace, including satellite. And the countries met in Seoul. Seoul is the capital of South Korea. This another important news is Mahsa Amini's family blocked from the leaving Iran for EU Rights Prize. Mahsa Amini, a Iranian Kurdish woman who died in custody, have banned from the traveling to France to collect a top right. This important, you should remember, top right award. For whom? Mahsa Amini. From France. Okay. Awarded posthumously. She died age 2022 in September 2022. While being held by Iran religious police for allegedly breached the country's dress code for women. This also important. And another news of today is, this is last but not least, COP28 is important news. Held at Abu Dhabi, the president of this COP28 is Sultan Ahmed Al Jaber. In that, United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change came into force in 1994. UNFCCC was classified into two, that is annexed country, annexed nation and non-annexed nation. Annexed nation is developed country and non-annexed is developing countries. Annexed countries expected to finance clean energy development in non-annexed nation. Non-annexed countries are consist of developing who contributed minimally carbon in atmosphere. Madras, this is also important. Madras city. Madras city is zero carbon city, which is situated a few kilometers of Abu Dhabi. This is fully fossil free future. Another COP28 outcome is losses and damages. The losses and damages found a key outcome at last year talks. Last year talks is COP27, which is held in Egypt. Egypt, $750 billion has come. This is last news of today's discussion. Thank you for watching this video.